Okay, today we're doing one of my favorite dishes. Prior to going vegan, when I go to a restaurant, if I saw this on the menu, I had to have it, and that is shrimp and grits. Today, the star of the show are vegan shrimp. Yes, vegan shrimp. Okay, so this is a soy product. So mainly of soy and some other ingredients. You can see they're looking like some shrimp there. We'll also be using one of the vegan sausages and that smoked apple sage. We'll season this to make it more Cajun, similar to the, what is it, Andouille sausage. Hopefully I'm not messing that name up, and you know, some good old quick grits we'll be using for that. First we'll go ahead and get our shrimp. We'll just get those seasoned so they can marinate for a moment. Okay, so we're going to just get the shrimp and a little marinade here. We'll just be seasoning with some minced garlic, obe seasoning, and you know what? I think we need to. Okay. Please excuse the lawnmower people out the door if you can hear them. Okay, so minced garlic, obe seasoning, lemon juice, and seaweed sheet. And I'm just letting them marinate in that until I'm ready to put them in the pan. All right, so we'll take, and I'm gonna try to use measuring for this. Okay, so got a tablespoon of minced garlic. That in there. Obe seasoning. Teaspoon. Tablespoon of lemon juice. Let's get that mixed up. Tossed up. And we want to add the seasoning sheet. The seaweed sheet helps to add fishy flavor because it tastes like fish. Let me just break this up to pieces. You can cut it, I don't know. And it's fine. Breaking it up with my hands. I like it better. is one more seasoning I forgot. And that's Italian seasoning. I've got cheese going everywhere. Okay, so we're going to add some Italian seasoning as well. About a teaspoon Italian seasoning. Get these vegan shrimp right. Get them right. This is what our vegan shrimps look like. We're just gonna let those marinate till we get ready to cook them. All right. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get our sausage prepared, and we're using the vegan sausage by Phil Roast, smoked in apple sage, and we're just going to cut them up, and I want to season these to try to imitate andouille sausage, if I'm saying it right, andouille. So these are how the sausages come. They're in the plastic casing. If you're not familiar, and I'm just going to take that. And am I doing one or two sausages? All right, so plastic casing. Take them out of there. And I believe these are a soy product as well, if I'm not mistaken. And soy products are soybean. Okay, this is a wheat product made from wheat gluten. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the mock meats that vegans make. They use this wheat gluten flour, and it does some magic, and I can't explain it, but that's what this is made of, and some other spices and such. Okay, so I'm just gonna take my sausage and cut it long ways. And then utilities. So go ahead and get that other one cut and prepped. Oop. Oh, and the seasonings we'll be using is onion powder, garlic powder, smoked paprika, and some cayenne. All right. Okay, so we now have our sausage, our vegan sausage. This is two of the field roast apple and sage sausages, and I want to season them to emulate the andouille Cajun sausage. So I'm going to season with the garlic powder, cayenne pepper, smoked paprika, onion powder. I'm trying to use measurements, but I think I'll go a little smaller than a teaspoon. So let me get something smaller than that. Okay. All right, so we're gonna use a 1/4 teaspoon for this. And we're gonna do some onion powder. Four teaspoons of garlic powder. Smoked paprika. And cayenne pepper. Because this is a spicy sausage, but I don't think there is a vegan andouille sausage. At least I'm not sure where to find one. So I'm making one, as you can see here. All right. So we got that. We're gonna put a little bit of olive oil to just a little bit of fat on these sausages and to help that season stick. And that's probably like a, I don't know what was that. What we want to say that was. 1/4 teaspoon of oil. And we're just going to get all that. All these sausages. Get them some heat. And trying to get a little bit of color as well. Just let those sit and marinate till we get ready to cook. On to the next thing. On to the next thing. Okay, now we're going to get, we have a little bit of onions and peppers we'll be adding to this to get that prep. Have about a 1/4 of green, red, and yellow bell pepper and some sweet onion that we're going to just dice up real fine or however you like it. Okay, so this is what we're going for. Just want to do this. And this is what we're looking like on our dices. Okay, so half of a small onion, that's about all I'll be dicing up for this. This is just a portion of the onion, and I'll just continue to finish getting all that prepped. Okay, we're going to get our grits on. We have 4 cups of boiling water. I'm just going by the instructions off of the container of quick grits, and I'm going for 4 servings, and that's 4 cups of water, and we have 1 cup of grits. And we will stir those in. And I'm using a fork because we want to break it up. Make sure we don't have any clumps. And then we're gonna turn this down before it gets to popping. And I have pink Himalayan salt, 1/4 teaspoon. And like I said, I'm going straight off of the instructions on the container here. Reduce to medium low and cover for 5 to 7 minutes. Alexa, set timer for 6 minutes.
For how long?
6 minutes.
6 minutes, starting now.
I know we're gonna cook them longer than that, but like I said, I'm going off the instructions, and then we'll go from there. Okay, so our 6 minutes have went off, and let's see what our grits looking like. Now, you do not want to be burnt by no hot grits, so be careful. Be very careful. Okay, so like I said, I was going by the instructions. We did, you know, the 6 minutes. But I tend to cook my grits longer than what's on the instructions, and I'm just making sure that there are no clumps in the grits, that they're not sticking to the bottom of the pan or pot, and I'm just going to let them
keep doing what they do. Turn them down a little lower and just let them keep cooking to my desired readiness. Alright, let's check back on our grits. It's been probably about 5 more minutes. Alright, so it has thickened up. I don't know if you can see it, but that's what I'm looking for. More thickness. Keep my protection. Gotta keep that shield now. Grits. So, if you can see, that's how I like my grits. That's the thickness. It wasn't that thick at that 6 minute mark. All right. So now I'm going to add some butter. And we're gonna add a good amount of butter. Now all of this is to taste. This is to your taste, how you like your grits. So this is how much butter I'm putting in there. Vegan butter. I'm using, what kind of butter? What is this? Blue Bonnet plant butter. All right. That stirred in there. And at this point, I'm still not turning my grits off. I'm just gonna turn them down to low. And we're just gonna let them keep on going at a very low. And this butter will help with, you know, keeping it from sticking to the pot. Butter is working. I just want to give it a taste, and this is where I'm gonna see if I need to add any salt or pepper at this point. Okay, we need some more salt up in there. We definitely need more salt. And I'm gonna add some pepper and salt. I'm gonna add a pinch of pepper. And a pinch of pink Himalayan salt. See? Too much. Trying to make my pinch too big. Loosen it. Alright, so let's get that stirred up. And now that we turn it down, grits are not popping as much. Just actually take my shield away so I can see properly. All right. Good nice thick grits like that. Sit on your plate, they ain't gonna be running. Give them a little taste, another taste. Let's see. What we're working with.
I know them things hot.
Might need a little bit more salt, but just make sure I got it stirred real good. Because we'll be adding a little bit of cheese to this as well. You got to taste your food. I think I need a little bit more salt. Okay. Another pinch of salt. And I'm gonna add some cheese as well. Let me taste it again. All right, we have enough salt. And I'll be adding, and I got a small amount of cheese, kale, vegan cheese, plant-based cheese. I'll be adding that to it. Now I'm just going to put all of this in here because I have a small amount in this bag. Let's see. If I can give you a measure. This is about almost a cup of cheese. It's not quite there. And we'll put that in there. And these grits are about to be done. But we will continue. Like I said, we'll continue. I'll just keep them on real low. Because no one wants cold grits. With look. Alright. Just keep that on low. Grits are done. Now we can get the rest going. And that's how you do a grit. Keep it gritty. Alright, it's time to get our sausages on. We have our pan heated up. Some olive oil, about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Put the sausage in here, our pre-seasoned vegan sausage. And we're just gonna brown these.
them vegan sausages. You see them. Who say vegan can't have sausage? Who say? Hey. I'm telling you, we have so many misconceptions about the vegan life and food, and I'm telling you, I was one of them. I'm like, I'm not eating salads every day. It has evolved so much. I'm just getting into the game all late. They have everything. I'm telling you, they have vegan everything. You can get the sausages and the cheese and the sour cream and the shrimp, as you see, you know, or you can keep it natural and make your own. Get the fresh produce and so forth with the mushrooms, make your own sausage with tofu. The sky is the limit. That is why I like this vegan life so much. The creativity is just crazy. How people can come up with some things like carrot dogs, and it's amazing. I love it. I am loving it. I'm gonna make my own sausage. Coming soon. Stay tuned. Coming soon. She's gonna make some homemade sausage. Yes, I am. Just wait. All right, them sausages looking good. Just want to get a little bit more brown on them. Turn it up a little bit. Maybe I need to turn it up a little bit more. This is what we're looking like. And this is pretty much what I'm going for here. All right. I'm going to go ahead and get these all out of there. Gonna come right behind this with our vegan shrimp. About 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Alright, let's get it. So we have our vegan shrimp. Let's get them out of here. They've been in here quite some time. And we're just gonna put little seaweed in there too. All in good flavor. Take it right up in there. This is not meat, so we're just gonna warm them through. Try to get a little bit of color on them. About 1 to 2 minutes on each side. That's all we need here. Okay, I think that'll go a little bit more easier. Vegan shrimp looking mighty good, ain't they? Yes, it makes me want to sing. Makes me want to shout.
marinara. What you say? Can you see?
Yeah. I'm gonna say that this is not meat, so. And if it was, it doesn't really take too long to cook shrimp, so. Let's get these on out of there. I think we're good on that. Got some good color on them. Got some good heat through and through. Alright, so we're going to take those on out. That's our vegan shrimp. Grits, grits looking good, just warming and chilling, waiting on the shrimp. Our shrimp. Now we're going to get our sauce. If you know anything about shrimp and grits, it is not just the shrimp and the grits. It's about that sauce. It's about the gravy. And we're about to get that going. This is what the vegan shrimp looking like. Not too bad, huh? Not too bad. Yeah. Alright, so we bring that thing right on back, and we're going to add some butter to the pan. See, we're not cleaning out the pan. We just want to take all those remaining flavor and just keep working with it. Keep it moving. Alright, so we add our vegan butter to the pan. We're going to follow that up with some onions and peppers. Remember the onions and peppers that we chopped up? Gonna put some of those in there. Well, all of those in there. And I got a tablespoon of minced garlic as well. Those all sauteed up. Too much, but can't have too much flavor. Can't have too much flavor. Just can't. smelling good. Mm. All right. And we're going to come right behind it. And add like a tablespoon of all purpose flour. Get us a little roux going on. A little roux. Recipe I'm following says to add seafood stock, which we don't have, so I had to make me some. And I have some, I have about a cup of this is veggie broth that I added the remainings of the seasoning that was left on the shrimp and a little bit of the nori for kake seasoning to give it an extra, some extra seafood flavoring. And that's how I made my seafood, vegan seafood broth. And it also states to add heavy cream, so I'll be using some almond milk. This time we are going to add our seasonings, and we will be adding onion powder, garlic powder, paprika, and Old Bay seasoning or the Cajun seasoning of your choice. You prefer Cajun seasoning. Teaspoon of onion powder. Teaspoon of garlic powder. To start anyways, because you know everything is to taste. You want to make sure it's what you would like it to be. Teaspoon of Old Bay, and then we're going to do a teaspoon of paprika. Paprika. I got to, sorry. And that's a paprika. So this is the secret right here. This right here is your secret on how good your shrimp and grits are going to be.
just put grits and shrimp together and say, hey, I got shrimp and grits. Oh, that ain't how that work. What that gravy tastes like is the question. What does that gravy taste like? You got the gravy right, then you just put those shrimp and sausages back in there, and you got a done deal. That's it. That's the done deal. Let me just taste this. Make sure it's where I want it to. Is it the thickness that I want it to be? Might need to add a little bit more flour to this. I think I do. I don't think it's thick as I would like it to be. We need to add a little bit more flour. Just a little bit more. That's not where I want you to be. And a little bit of more flour. That's going to give you a thickness. Flavor on. Perfecto. Right where I want it to be. Right where I want it to be. Maybe. I think I might want to add a little bit more obey. Add a little bit more obey. I've already turned that off. I turned it off because our sausage and shrimp are done. We're just pretty much gonna fold those in once you get that brew or gravy or whatever you call it, right? That's it. Once you get that right. Once you get that right, you're done. Add a little bit more obey in there. I want to get a little bit more obey. Gonna take it off of the heat. Add a little bit more obey to it. Do that. Teaspoon obey. I gotta eat that by itself. It is chunky. Okay. take our vegan sausage, pull it back in there. Oh, that looks good, don't it? That looks so good and delicious. Vegan shrimp. You know what? I should be leaving some of those on the side to top. I'm gonna take these out. I'm gonna keep a few of those right there for garnish. I should have did that with the sausage as well, but I wasn't even thinking. You know what? Matter of fact, no, I ain't. Because they looking pretty nice right by themselves. I'm going to put them shrimp right on back on in here. You don't need no garnish. Bam! Just like that. Because this is looking very nice. Very nice. Very good. I must say, very good, I must say. What you say? How is vegan dish looking to you right now? Scrumptious, yeah. I agree, scrumptious. Because them flavors are on point. I say them flavors are on point. If you can't see, let's bring you in a little bit more into this goodness. Bam! All right. We're ready to get this thing plated. We don't even have to play at all. Look at that. Hit it with some green onion. Just hit it with a couple of green onions here and there. You know, a little bit of garnish. Just a little bit. All right, so let's bring you in. You know, we got to get those pictures. All right, there we go. Vegan shrimp and grits. Yes, this is it. This is the finished product. Must say, feeling pretty proud. Feeling pretty proud about this dish. Yes, I am. What'd you think? All right. This is not my first time. This will be my second time. But we'll go ahead and get it tasted for you. All right, let's get into it. All right. Sausage is good. Vegan sausage. This is, I don't know about any other brands, but this one is pretty official. Seasonings there. Flavor there. Get that vegan shrimp. All right there. Good texture. Yeah, they did a good job on this. These vegan shrimp, imitation shrimp. Texture is good. Got good flavor. You had imitation crab meat before. This is your imitation shrimp, whether you're vegan or not. And I must say, this company
did a good job. I thought I was done with shrimp and grits. This was a success, if you didn't even know. It's good. This is good. I'm telling you, I was not a believer until I had to try it. I had to try it. I'm sorry, because I watched other vegan cooks, and I see the shrimp, and I'm just like, no, I'm not doing that. That's a little bit too much now, y'all getting carried away. But I had to try it, because I'm just like, I got to find it. I got to try it. Found them. And this is the first recipe that I tried. Like I said, this is one of my favorite dishes. I had to figure out how to get it in the vegan life. The grits on point. You know, they just been simmering down, just doing what they do. Good, thick, flavorful. Got that vegan cheese in there, the KO, Cheo. It's a very creamy cheese. Wish I had more, but I still taste it. I'm still eating. This is that good. I'm sorry. But I'm going to go ahead and sit down and actually enjoy this even more. This was a success.